came across this old legend about happiness. In ancient Greece, the gods wanted to hide happiness away from people. One of the gods wanted to hide it in the tallest mountain, but they soon realized that people would be able to get there. Another god came with the idea to hide it in the bottom of the ocean, but it still wasn't good enough. So the third god decided to hide happiness in the heart of every person, and they all agreed that that was the best place possible. And from that moment, happiness hides in our hearts, and all our lives we seek it without knowing that we already have it. What a beautiful parable, and how true. We seek happiness like it is a material thing with bells and whistles. And of course, the internet is filled with quotes about happiness and butterflies and all that jazz. But when you're caught in the whirlpool of negativity and sadness, it's a bit hard to remember and harder still to believe. So here's what this episode will do for you. We will look at the simplest way to find happiness within you. Hi, I'm Sheila and this is Lumiere 24. Light on! The Dalai Lama says that happiness is not something ready-made. It comes from our own actions. You know how it is. Some days we fly out of bed ready to take on the world, and on other days we have ankle weights that drag us down. But I have realized this. Like everything in life, happiness is also a habit, and we have to consciously choose it every single day, every single time. Now, I'm not asking you to be a Pollyanna, but happiness comes from how you think about yourself, your life, and the world around you. The simplest way to change your mind is to change your physiology, your body language. Have you noticed how hard it is to feel negative and down in the dumps when you straighten your shoulders and just smile? So the first thing to practice is to carry yourself strong and straight. No slumped shoulders and downward curving mouth. Science suggests that when you smile, whether you're happy or not, your mood is elevated, especially if all your facial muscles, including the ones around your eyes, get involved. So smile whenever you can. Smiling is like a feedback loop. It reinforces happiness. Just as happiness causes smiling, smiling reinforces happiness. Smiling releases endorphins, which are associated with pain relief, and serotonin, which is associated with happy feelings. So whenever you pass your reflection, smile. Whenever you pass people in the street, smile. Remember, in some cultures, they will be suspicious when you smile, but that's okay. You're doing it for yourself. Give up the comparison game. And with social media, it's all too easy to fall into the trap. You look at other seemingly accomplished lives, holidays, and spouses, and immediately feel smaller, less than, unhappy. Stop. It's important to remember that someone else's success isn't your failure. You're different people with different lives. In the end, what everyone else is doing has little or no impact to your own success. Believe this. This is actually a lot more important than finding things that make you happy. Are you in a toxic relationship? Do you dislike your job? Are you eating a lot of unhealthy food? These things all need to go before you start to seek happiness. Otherwise, they can hold you back. One of the ways to do this is being conscious of what your core values in life are. Check if everything you do, be, or have is congruent with those values. Often, employees' dissatisfaction with their jobs can be traced back to a mismatch in core values. If your company does not value the same things that you do, you'll feel unhappy. When you're in a funk, the last thing you want to do is be around others. Resist that at all cost. Life is about relationships. It's about connections. Happy people can change your mood in an instant. Just be sure you choose carefully. Know who you enjoy being around, who brings you up, and who encourages positivity. Anyone who doesn't fit this bill is not worth your time, ever. It amazes me how many people continue to spend time around negative people who bring them down. Life's too short. Choose wisely. If you can't find enough happy people, spend time with children, a pet, or even nature. Yeah, I know you've heard this before, but most unhappiness is because we're either living in the past or in the future. One way to be in the present is, you guessed it, meditation. There is no escape. Sit down, stare at a wall, focus on your breath, let the thoughts come and go. Slowing down, taking a pause, all these keep your focus in the now. And even though you may not realize it, as meditation becomes a way of life, you will see your happiness meter rise. If you have never meditated before, start with just 1 minute a day, 2 or 3 times a day, and increase it gradually. If my really young clients can learn to do it, what's your excuse? And right here, I hand you the one tool that always, always helps. Look for what you can appreciate. So often we can be so laser focused on what we want and what we don't have. We totally neglect to appreciate what we do have. Don't feel guilty. We all fall victim to this ungrateful attitude. So here's one of my favorite tools to tip the happiness scales. I like to call it my sunshine project. This is what you do. Get a glass jar. Every day, on separate slips of paper, write down all the nice things that have happened to you that day. You made it to work on time? Write that down. Your friend told you a hilarious joke and you laughed till you cried? Write that down. Your morning cup of coffee was perfect? Write it. Your kid hugged you tight? Write it. Your partner and you had a moment? Write it. You came back to a clean, fresh smelling house? Write that down. No traffic on way to the office? Write it. You get the drift, right? Write it all down and put it in your jar. And every day as you look at the jar being filled with pieces of appreciative stuff, you will realize that you are indeed blessed. Two tips here. One, use multicolored stationery. I found nicely shaped post-it slips. I use that. It makes the jar so much more beautiful to look at. Tip 2. Do it before you go to bed every night. It might all sound a little too mushy and woo-woo for you, but I promise it works. This technique pulls your attention off all those things that you don't have and all those things that didn't go right throughout the day, and instead makes you remember all the things, big and small, that you should appreciate. Instead of falling asleep, obsessing over how unhappy you are, you're now focusing on things that went well. And remember what I said in the beginning? Happiness is a habit. And this is a surefire way to retrain your brain to look for the good. It also has a scientific name to make you feel important: reticular activation system. And of course you know this, what you focus on grows. I love this tool. This is something that I do every day. In fact, every year on December 31st, I empty my jar and look at all those lovely things that happened throughout the year. It helps me close my year with a warm glow. Now, don't wait till the end of the year. Start today. Start now. And let me know how it works out for you. And share this tool with your family and friends. You can even start a family sunshine jar. Encourage everyone to put small slips of paper with all the things that made them smile during the day. It'll be great fun. And it will help in creating a happy vibe in your home. Spread the light, folks. Like and share this video and subscribe. Press the bell icon. And if you have subscribed, get a few friends to subscribe too.